In this video, I am going to explain three muscles that have relationship with hip joint. 1, 2, 3. This one is gluteus minimus. Gluteus minimus. This one is rectus femoris. This one is vastus lateralis. This combination is kind of weird, but why am I talking about these three muscles today? Because they have myofascial connection with hip joint. Let me explain that. This is ligament of hip. This part is iliofemoral ligament. Iliofemoral ligament. These three muscles are very close to this ligament. Let's go to gluteus minimus. This muscle is very close to this ligament. There is myofascial connection between gluteus minimus and this ligament. So it's like a bridge between ligament and muscle. There is connection about this area, okay? Gluteus minimus and ligament. Let's talk about rectus femoris. Origin of rectus femoris is AIIS, anterior inferior iliac spine, AIIS. But part of its origin is very close to hip joint. This muscle attaches to edge of pelvis. Imagine it attaches right here. It's very, very close to hip joint, right? Rectus femoris attaches to edge of pelvis where it is very close to hip joint, hip ligament, okay? Rectus femoris. Now, vastus lateralis. This muscle also has myofascial connection with this ligament. This is a little bit far away compared to distance between muscle and ligament from gluteus minimus and rectus femoris. However, vastus lateralis also has fascial connection with ligament. Okay, I will repeat that. Gluteus minimus, right here. Rectus femoris, here. Vastus lateralis, here. Okay, does it make sense? I am talking about this connection now from a French anatomy book. I didn't see this myofascial connection from American anatomy book, so I think this is very rare and interesting connection. So, what if one of these muscles get tight? Let's say gluteus minimus gets tight. That can pull hip joint, of course, and myofascial connection and ligament. What if rectus femoris gets tight? That also can affect hip joint. What happens when vastus lateralis gets tight? This tightness can also tighten up myofascia, which is ligament. Right? I think these three muscles have important role for hip stabilization and hip function. Personally, I focus on lateral part of hip muscle, such as gluteus medius and also gluteus minimus. I feel when these muscles get tight, that can affect hip movement and hip stability. This group is very, very important. That is maybe from this myofascial connection. Let's look at rectus femoris. I feel when this muscle gets tight, this tightness can affect anterior tightness of hip joint. Of course, this tightness is literally from rectus femoris. But think about it. This muscle has connection with hip joint. So the tightness of anterior part of hip is not only from rectus femoris, but also from hip joint because of myofascial connection. So, vastus lateralis looks like there is no effect for hip joint because this muscle does not cross hip joint like other two muscles. But if you think about myofascial connection, tightness of vastus lateralis may affect hip joint because of myofascial connection. I'm not saying these three muscles always affect dysfunction of hip, but if you think about this myofascial connection, you can see hip dysfunction from different view. Okay, I hope this video helps you understanding of new angle of hip joint. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.